Good evening, everybody. I'm Anamika Modi. I'll be presenting my topic, Creating a Web-Based Generalized Solution for Remote Triggered Labs. Now, basically, firstly, what is Remote Triggered Labs? So basically, it's providing laboratory facilities virtually. So here, basically, experimental setups are hooked up over internet, and they can be then used by, they can be made available to everybody. So out of those many experimental setups that have been hooked up, the one I have worked with is SBHS. This is basically used in control systems. So we can think of it as a black box for now, which has two inputs, that will be heat and fan, and one output temperature. So here Scilab is used. Basically, the SBHS acts as a plant, and Scilab acts as a controller. So basically, Scilab is here used for writing controller codes so that run on plants. That is SBHS. So there is already an existing solution. So which is a Python Django, which is based on Python Django framework. But there are certain problems with that framework, so I basically worked on improving that. So what happens in the already existing solution is the Scilab runs on the client side. So the final interface that the user sees is Scilab. So basically the main aim here was to move Scilab onto the server side. Also, when Scilab was on the client side, the problem was in certain network delays were introduced, because the problem was the values that were being transferred to the SBHS on the which was on the virtual lab server was now transport the values that were generated by Scilab were transported via internet to SBHS. So the problem was the if the user has a slow network connection, then the values get transported later, and then the network delays are introduced basically. So the new server architecture is like this, where Scilab is introduced on the server side. So here's, we have a Java application that talks with the Scilab, and it communicates with the SBHS too. So we have a website for it, and the design is basically, we have a registration login mechanism, a slot booking mechanism, and there are two kind of experiments that we conduct, an open loop experiment and a closed loop experiment. Under open loop experiment, it's basically, it does not involve Scilab, it's basically certain inputs are given to the, are passed by the user to SBHS, and the outputs are then taken from SBHS and passed back to the user. While in a closed loop experiment, we include Scilab, that is basically for writing control algorithms. For talking to Scilab, before we had to introduce something so that the Java application is able to call Scilab. For that, we use the Java SCI API. I'll show you the demo now.
How many concurrent Scilab instances can be created simultaneously?
Yes, sir. So this was a problem that was faced earlier too. So the thing was, we have tried it multiple times, but the Java SCI library does not support multiple instances for now. So we had to talk to Scilab community too. So the conclusion finally was that the Java SCI library isn't strong enough to support this. To support multiple instances, we were basically thinking of shifting it to maybe Scilab cloud, or maybe running multiple Scilab instances through the terminal, because basically what we require is a non-GUI form, because all the charts that we are generating is through JavaScript on the browser.
So right now it is a single user solution.
Yeah, the login page, the book sort page, we can book a slot for now. Now this will allow me to use the machine. So basically for now, this is the interface. Now I'll be uploading a file that I want to run. And I can give whatever name I want to save it with. There'll be certain inputs. An iteration rate. Iteration rate will basically define the cycle. That is the rate I want to keep between the Scilab and the SBHS communication. So yeah, it runs like this. So after this, basically we have the stop and the pause function. Basically it can pause the entire experiment for some time. Stop button will enable me to start a new experiment. We have a 55-minute slot for every user. After the slot is finished, the user is not allowed to use the same machine. He has to book another slot. So, and we have an experimental log that is created, and yeah, that's it.
Next.